Okay, the examination of the abdomen should also include the auscultation. Really, in the auscultation of the abdomen, one should listen for bowel sounds, and one should listen for the arterial brewery, and for friction rub, and for venous hum. Really, the following points are suggested to be auscultated. First of all, one should listen over a McBurney point. The McBurney point really is a point between lateral 1/3 and medial 2/3, over which stethoscope should be applied and listen for bowel sounds. Really, the comment here about the bowel sound, you have just to comment whether the bowel sound is present or absent. You haven't the right to say absent bowel sound unless 2 minutes are passed and you cannot hear any bowel movement. While bowel sound, if it is present, sometimes the bowel sound appears to be a low pitch and rumbling in character, which is suggestive of, for example, in hungry patients and in carcinoid syndrome and severe GI bleeding and so on. And sometimes it has a high pitch with tinkling character when there is a fluid plus air inside the bowel. That's to say it is a characteristic of abdominal obstruction. Really, but during clinical training, we comment upon the bowel sound of just present or absent. You can also comment about its presence, of whether it is a low pitch, high pitch, tinkling in character, or rumbling in character, and so on. Then after this point, you have to check over the right hypochondrium for the presence of hepatic friction rub and hepatic brewery. Really, brewery means systolic murmur that is discontinuous, not continuous, but well localized and may be heard here due to, for example, AV malformation or hepatocellular carcinoma. Friction rub occurred due to perihepatitis here, whether due to inflammation or due to malignancy. After that, one should listen over the left hypochondrium for splenic brewery and for splenic friction rub. Really, splenic brewery here may suggest also AV malformation, and the friction rub may suggest perisplenitis. After that, listen over the implicus for venous hum. Venous hum is different from hepatic brewery in that the venous hum is also a murmur, systolic murmur, but it is continuous. The origin of it is from the vein rather than from the artery, as in the case of hepatic brewery. Its presence here really suggests the presence of portal hypertension, and the sign here is called Kinaway sign. After that, listen over the implicus for abdominal aortic atherosclerosis for brewery, and also below the implicus for the bifurcation of the aorta. You may hear systolic brewery in case of atherosclerosis. After that, 2 to 3 centimeters above and lateral to the implicus here, listen for renal artery stenosis with the resultant brewery. After that, listen over the femoral vessel also for the presence of systolic brewery, which assist in the diagnosis of generalized atherosclerosis. Lastly, in the auscultation of the abdomen, one should really practice what we call the succession splash. But before that, we have to ask the patient one question and to tell him that we are going to perform such a maneuver. حماد بسرح أخض البطن معك مشكلة؟ أوكي. إيش قد صار لك من ماكل أو شارب مي تقريبا؟ أكثر من 4 ساعات. أوكي. If the period elapsed more than 4 hours, any succession splash here is significant. While less than this period of about 2 hours or less than 2 hours, less than 4 hours, is less significant. First of all, I should practice the succession splash without a stethoscope in such a manner. I'll just quickly and rhythmically shake the chest and listen for any succession splash. And then I should listen via the stethoscope by shaking also the chest of the patient. If there is any succussion splash really mimicking the sounds obtained when a bottle is filled into its half amount with water and then shake. The sound is similar to that. Once you finish the auscultation of the abdomen, you have to get a permission from the examination committee that you would like to perform genital examination and to check for the anus, rectum, and to perform digital rectal examination, check for hernial orifices, and lastly for the renal angle tenderness. Really, I'll omit all these issues and you can read about it in your textbook of clinical examination, but I'll show you the way of how to check for renal angle tenderness in such a manner. Okay, first of all, you have to know where is the renal angle. Renal angle or costovertebral angle, from the back, the lowest portion of the back, the lowest portion, this is the lowest portion. This is the 12th rib, and here also the 12th rib. First of all, you have to check it with your thumb in such a manner and check your patient if he had been winced or not, that's to say he felt that there is a pain. If it is not obtained by this maneuver, you have to percuss with a fist. Okay, just like this. If any tenderness is elicited here, this is an indication for renal angle tenderness and may indicate a pathology there. Okay, after that, we had finished the examination of the abdomen, and I am greatly thankful for your listening.